Hey everyone, welcome to another cube draft here on ChannelFireball.com. This is, of course, the powered cube. You can tell because I opened a piece of power. And I will, in fact, be taking it. Time Walk is a pretty nice place to start, passing up on both Volcanic and Delta, which is kind of brutal because I think blue-red's the best color combination, but that's all right. We're still taking Time Walk. Also passing up on Jite, Search, Frez, Kanta, some pretty good cards. Pretty good chance we wheel Seething Song, which is something worth keeping in mind in case somehow we end up in Storm. All right, well, the second pick I don't think is too hard. Misty Rainforest just goes really well with Time Walk. After that, there's Gitaxian Probe and Geist of Sandtrap. Both are pretty good, but taking a blue fetch is really powerful, especially since we know we're not going to have access to a couple of the blue duels because of Volcanic and Blue Delta being gone. Next up, we've got Riftwing Cloudsgate. Is it Charm? Corsair of Kruphix is actually kind of reasonable with Misty. Corsair's a great combo with Misty and actually a pretty good combo with Time Walk. Then there's Looter, Firebolt, Plateau isn't horrible, and Avalanche Riders and Augur are both worse, so really comes down to, I think, Cloudsgate versus Corsair. I think Corsair's a little better, but you have to be base green, which we're not yet, whereas Cloudsgate, I think, is just an overall good card. I've been just very impressed with this card in Cube. I think I'm just going to take the Cloudsgate. I don't see a particular reason to be green quite yet, though even if we end up green, blue-green with Cloudsgate is pretty good. All right, this is, I think, a pretty easy Solemn Simulacrum. There is a Battle Ball. I do like Mirror Battlesphere, but I like Solemn a lot, and it gives you a lot of flexibility. Don't really like Control Magic all that much. I'll play it, but it's not a high pick, and then Show and Tell, I think, is really bad. And I don't see a particular reason to take any of the off-color cards here. So, all right, start to your average cube deck, I suppose. Ooh, we could take Gilded Lotus and be a big mana deck. We haven't done that for a draft or two. there's also Tendrils and Gush and Ancient Grudge. I find Grudge to be quite strong. I don't see this as being a great Storm start, nor have we seen, besides the one Seething Song, a lot of reasons to be Storm. I do like Grudge. I found Grudge to be very strong, and I have a Misty, so it's going to be kind of easy to splash. Then again, Gilded Lotus is just really sweet if you kind of get there. Ooh, I like Commit to Memory a lot. I found this to be a good disruptive card, and then Flashing Back Memory is a very real thing you can do. Passing up on Force Spike and Chrome Mox, I think it is fine to pass up on those. I'll just pick up a Daze now. I'm nearly mono blue. Daze is pretty strong. I'm not all that high on Terastron or Tessie Gray or Armageddon for that matter, whereas I do like Daze quite a bit. Okay, so we've got two different lands here, Botanical Sanctum and Wandering Fumarole. There's also Rishat in port, but I think it's worse than one of the two lands. I already have a blue-green land, but blue-red is a much more likely place to end up, so I think I'm just going to take the Fumarole over Sanctum. Maybe I'll wheel Volcanic Island. I will not wheel Volcanic Island. So, what did wheel? Well, the Seizing Song did, but I don't really think we're there. I could take Ravages. Having another way to blow up all, or having a way to blow up all lands is reasonable in deck with like Solemn, Gilded Lotus, Riftwing Cloudsgate. I don't really like Bloodfast. I think it's really good in blue-black, but don't see a reason to quite go there yet. I actually might take Seething Song. Find a blue-red Wildfire slash big mana I can see running it. Wow, Geist Wield? Huh. So did Searing Spear, but this is actually the start of a very good Geist of Sandtrap deck. I've got Riftwing, Daze, Time Walk, Commit to Memory. I could take that and Audible kind of into blue-white. We'll see how this goes. Well, all these cards are playable, so where do we want to go? We've got three spells so far, so Augur's not looking the best. I do like Firebolt in general, but Geist is good, and Gideon goes reasonably well. I think Gideon to be pretty underpowered, though. I think I'm just going to take Duplicant in case I end up like the big mana artifact deck, and I think this card is just kind of playable already. Now, Lyra is a very specific card. You want that post-board against certain matchups. I think I'm just going to take Needle Spires. I like lands. Okay, Linvala is very good in some matchups as well. Against like the mono-green deck, can be quite good. Thalia is a great hate card. And then Echo Pop. All right, so white does seem to be open. Could end up in blue-white. We'll see what we open pack two here. There is a Burning of Xinyi, so the Wildfire Dream could be alive. I could also just take Grim Monolith. There's also Impulse. I kind of like Grim Monolith when I have Gilded Lotus, Duplicant, Commit to Memory, Solemn all in my deck. Though Jace Architect of Thought is nice with Time Walk. Time Walk's really good with Planeswalkers. But I'm just going to take Grim Monolith. White is really open. I could take Jace again and end up more blue-white. I'm not really liking Impulse all that much here. I mean, I've got Time Walk, but I don't have that many individual cards I'm trying to put together. You know what? I'm just going to take Grim Monolith. All right. Let's see if we can get some manas here. Well, we can. There's a Basalt Monolith and a Rakdos Signet. I find Signet to be a little better than Basalt Monolith. I don't think this card's great. Skull Clamp, but we're not really there. I'm just going to take Mana Leak. Mana Leak is always good. And there's a Tropical Island there. Green has not seemed open at all. Ooh. Baneslayer to go with Lyra. There's Metamorph and Phantasmal Image. This deck probably wants Metamorph more. The one reason to take Phantasmal Image is that it combines very nicely with Sun Titan, which we haven't seen, which we haven't passed on yet. So, yeah, looking at my spells over here, it's probably got to be Metamorph. I have Gilded Lotus in my deck, and there's a chance I might want to copy that. I'm really hating Lightning Tutor. I'm not really looking to do that. I don't like Gideon Jura all that much. I could Lotus Petal, but unless you're comboing, Lotus Petal is pretty medium. I could Sword of Feast and Famine. It's just not the direction I'm going here, though. Can't fight the tide forever. I guess Enlightened Tutor gets a bunch of different things, but putting myself down a card for that is just so bad. I'm just going to take Gideon Jura. Gideon's good if you end up playing a little bit more controlling. All right, well, I've got to take Celestial Colonnade here. Sorry, Splinter Twin and Chandra. White is just more open. I have to take the White Land. Sadly, Hallowed Fountain's gone, so if we see Tundra, we have to take it over basically everything. Because if we take a look at the lands we have, this is our only blue-white fixer. We have a Misty, which doesn't do much yet, and then Needle Spies and Fumarole. If I end up playing red, but I don't even have a red card yet. Ah, that stupid Metamorph pick. Because here's the Sun Titan. I am going to take it. Sun Titan is just really good, and it's good so far with... Well, actually, just Geist. Sun Titan's still better than Wall of Omens. I can pick up ways to make Sun Titan good. This is a good big mana card for a deck playing like Grim Monolith. Oh, I have a fetch land too. So, a little punished on the Metamorph pick, but we'll see how things end up. So no cards I'm gonna play here. I'm not in for Silverblade Paladin or Brain Freeze. I could just take Verdant. It's very far from what I want right now, but it could open the door if I just get a couple different duels. That's a little thin. I could take Deccanstone. It is a way to interact with the opponent. And I could also take Edric and splash it off like a Misty. That doesn't seem fantastic. I'll just take Verdant, knowing that I'm likely to not play Verdant Catacombs at the end of the day. Ooh, I do like Sphinx's Revelation when I have Grim Monolith and Gold Lotus. Okay, I could be more of a blue-white control deck. The blue-white Cheons, as they say. I think we're actually pretty well set up for that. And we have Geist because it's just a Miser card, but the rest of these cards do work towards control. Same with Blade Splicer. That's a good defensive card. You can, and it works nicely with Sun Titan, so passed up on Burning. We're just not, at this point, not playing, looking to play red. Okay, I think we're in good shape here. Wow, nothing wheeled out of this pack. This pack had a lot of stuff in it. I'll take Selfless Spirit, though I'm not all that likely to end up playing it. Same with Baneslayer Angel, a fine sideboard card more than anything else. Mutavault, if my mana somehow ends up playable. Chandra, if I end up in red. Dante Vanguard's not really where I want either. Alright, so this is pretty good. I don't know, I have 15 playables going to the third pack with some options on the others, and then not really a Thalia deck, but I can side that in. I could see playing Linval. That's also more of a sideboard card. What I'm really trying to pick up is a blue-white duel to enable this Misty Rainforest, but we'll see if we can stumble across one of those here. Of course, something like Ancestral Recall or Sol Ring wouldn't hurt either. I wouldn't turn one of those down. Ooh, on the other hand, we have an opposition. Not a Time Twister, sadly, and we're not Pestermiting, but opposition with Blade Splicer is pretty good. I can pick up some more creatures. I can at this point play like the Selfless Spirit. And opposition I found just to be a really strong card, and I think it's going to go quite nicely in this deck. Alternately, I could take Elesh Norn, but that's only good in some matchups, so I'm just going to take Opposition. I think Opposition is a great win condition. And Elesh Norn might wheel. One of those two might wheel, so we'll see which one. Oh, there's Bribery and there's Recruit of the Guard. Recruit of the Guard gets Riftwing, Selfless Spirit, Blade Splicer, Geist, Metamorph. Recruiter's really good in this deck. There's also Wrath and Chart of Course, both of which I'd be interested in. Though Wrath a little less so now that I picked up Opposition. But Bribery is just busted. When you bribery someone, you just win most of the time. So I'm going to take bribery and then hope the recruiter wheels, which it frequently does. There's also a couple other random nice cards in that pack. Too late, Kikijiki. I might banish a priest. I don't think we're Tezzeret the Seeker Ring. We're not on that realm. Banish a priest is a decent removal spell that you can get back with Sun Titan. No Kikis. Hostage Taker is nice, but I have a Verdant Catacombs as the closest I have to black fixing, so my mana is already at this point going to be pretty bad. I've got one duel. If I can pick up exactly Tundra to fetch with Misty, I think my mana gets a lot better. Though, I guess if I pick up Savannah or Temple Garden, I think Temple Garden already passed, but Savannah would help this Misty make blue and white, so that is another option as well. Thing of the Ice, five, not enough. Repeal, though. Repeal's a fine card. I'm not going to play Academy Ruins, Lotus Bloom, Iona, no. Plus, it's an X spell, so I can put it anywhere, so I'm going to put it in my 3-drop slot to look like my curve is better. Classic opposition Guild Lotus deck, though I think Lotus is fine here. Thalia might actually be playable, even though I've got Sphinx's Rev and opposition in my deck. Well, partially because I have opposition. She is a mana disruptive element. Mutavault kind of wants to get in there with opposition also. Linvala is interesting. All right, let's assume Linvala gets in. Ooh, I do like Mox Diamond. Mox Diamond helps fix my mana and helps me ramp out some of these cards. Brainstorm, I've got currently Misty as my only shuffle effect. Yeah, Mox Diamond is also a combo Sun Titan. You discard a land and then you play Sun Titan a turn earlier and then you get Mox Diamond, the land you discarded to Mox Diamond back. See, that's a combo. Ooh, so is Moldrifter, though. Elspeth Sun's Champion opposition is a nice combo. There's also Mirror Crusader, which I don't like. Mystical, which is bad even with Time Walk and Bribery in my deck. And then Everflowing Chalice, which I think is fine, but I think I'd rather just take Moldrifter. I've got a Metamorph. Having copy effects when you have Moldrifter is nice, and I might wheel Recruiter of the Guard, so... Yeah, I would like some card draw. Ooh, Emeria Angel to go with opposition is really good. I do like Lark in this deck. Oh, this is a tough pick. Take Linvala out. I'm kind of thinking it's Emeria Angel as much as I like Lark. I don't have Restoration Angel to bounce it. I just have Repeal. Yeah, I'm just going to have to go that way. Ooh, Soulfire Grandmaster. I'm going to take that because even though Ojutai is nice, I have a lot of fives and Soulfire Grandmaster Time Walk because it's nice two-card infinite. And this card's already playable by itself. I can buy back a Mana Leak or a Repeal or something like that. But having the two-card Time Walk combo is pretty sick. So, yeah. Wow. I really hope Recruiter of the Guard wheels. It was Recruiter of the Guard versus... where did I take over Recruiter of the Guard? It was something really close. Did it not wheel? Oh, it was Bribery, yeah. Okay, this is my opening pack. I'm going to take Land Tax, though. None of these cards are playable. I guess Mox Diamond is nice with Land Tax, I suppose. All right. Any Recruiter of the Guards, it can get so many cards in my deck. And I have opposition to make it good, and I have Sun Titan to bring it back. I still think the raw power of Bribery is a justification for it, but didn't get there. I'll take Wrath, even though I'm definitely not main decking Wrath in this deck. So I need to cut a bunch of cards. I can cut this Selfless Spirit, I think. I like all the spells. Could also cut Gideon Jura. And this leaves me with 17 land plus Mox Diamond. No blue-white duel, sadly. The mana on this is going to be a little rough. I probably can't afford Mutavault despite the interaction with opposition. I probably just have to... I'm still going to run Misty for a Mary Angel and Sun Titan, but I'll take Wear Terror as a chance I set this in. But I think my mana is going to be tough. I'm going to have to add... Yeah, just playing a Colonnade or Mox Diamond and then the rest are just Plains and Islands. So, not where I want to be, but... I don't think I Bloom. I could Lodestone Golem. It's probably not where I want to be. It's a shame Recruit of the Guard didn't wheel. I imagine that it got taken by whoever wanted Kikijiki, but... It would have been sweet. Well, Mirror Crusader is at least a fine sideboard card. I have a good sideboard. I have Mirror Crusader, Silverblade Paladin, Baneslayer Angel, Wrath of God, Gideon Jura. I can side into a pretty good control deck against Aggro, and against Storm, I have Clark Wield. Oof, I am in for that. Okay, that was sick. So now, I was about to take out the Duplicant, but I guess Lark and Duplicant's pretty nice. So I want to play... Maybe it should be 8-7 in terms of white, because I have Misty for blue, so it's just basically 8-8. Yeah, I think even split is fine. But I still do need to cut a card. And maybe it is actually the Duplicant, now that I look at it. I still have Banisher Priest. And Bribery, Metamorph. Yeah, I've got some removal. I like Daze in this deck. I actually could take Thalia out. Maybe I'll take out Thalia and then board Thalia in if it seems appropriate. I mean, I have so many creatures in my deck. Thalia is really powerful. I'll do this. All right, let's get in there. Alrighty, time for round one. And yeah, we're in for this. Like, this hand doesn't have any blue. We're paying the price in game one of our kind of medium mana base for by cube standards. But if I do draw blue, I get to evoke Moldrifter and I get a Time Walk. So it catches me back up pretty quickly. Plus, Opposition and Suntan are both very powerful. So I think this hand is overall a keep, even though, you know, it could use some help. On the other hand, if I peel Mox with exactly this card, Mox Diamond, then I'm in really good shape. Jeez, I'm jealous of my opponent's mana. Okay, but they didn't do anything. So I guess I'm just gonna pass the turn. They fetched Plateau and said go. They have a nice little Jeskai deck. We'll see what spell they're getting out there. Chart a Course. Alright. So they discard an Electrolyze? Wow, their hand must be pretty decent. And they didn't play anything else. Okay. I've drawn a Plains and a 5-drop, which is not like exactly where I want to be. But if I draw Island, I'd probably just go Island. I'd probably evoke Moldrifter because then I can play Lark. There's some thought to going Island to Time Walk. And then next turn, just hard casting Moldrifter. But we'll see. I wouldn't mind drawing Misty Rainforest either. Putting a fetch in the graveyard for Sun Titan would be pretty nice. Ooh, what do we got? A Johnny Vengeant. Okay. Gilded Lotus. Okay, well that is a nice draw if I draw a land. I will say that in general, doing nothing until turn 5 in cube is not going to win you the game. Or really any format. So, I'm not particularly happy about how this is going. Well, my opponent might think I'm playing White Weenie. They probably don't. They probably think I'm playing Blue-White and didn't hit my second land. Okay, if it was a Vendilion Click, I might have just scooped. I'm pretty close to dead here. Do they have the Kiki Jiki to finish things off? Or the Splinter Twin to not? Johnny is ticking up. Their true name. Okay, things are getting worse. I'm not gonna lie. Let's see what we draw. Alright, well. Get to play Gilded Lotus and Time Walk. Assuming Gilded Lotus resolves, which I guess is not a given. But if I Gilded Lotus into Time Walk, I mean, that is some pretty decent action here. And then next turn I'll have 8 mana. I can evoke Moldrifter and play something else. No! Oh, I'm getting bolted? Okay, I don't get that. Now I draw a Mox Diamond. You betrayer. Let's see, I have 8 mana, so if I evoke Moldrifter, I'll have 5 mana. I would like to evoke Moldrifter and... Yeah, let's evoke Moldrifter with a blue left. This gives me some options here. At some point, I'm going to have to cast Commit Memory on a Johnny. But don't do that quite yet. Hey, maybe I do have to do it now? Because otherwise, I guess I just have to. Otherwise, my Gilded Lotus gets tapped out, and I really don't like that. Alright, I'll pass the turn, so I'm going to take 6, falling to 8. Like, this True Name is gonna clock me pretty hard. But maybe they'll have Elesh Norn in their deck to bribery for. Plus, if I bribery them next turn, they don't get to draw a Johnny. Okay. Selfless Spirit. So next turn, I get to bribery. So I have 8 and 9 mana, so 4 left over after I bribery. So probably Blade Splicer, but let's see what we hit with bribery now here. Playing just Jeskai midrange of some kind. Could be Kiki combo, I don't know. A Johnny, Teferi, Exquisite Firecraft, Fireball. Yeah, Mana Drain, Mystic Confluence. Okay, Nahiri. Stormbreath Dragon. Don't like much of these. How am I winning this game? I could Riftwing them. Doesn't accomplish a lot. I could just get a Stormbreath. Yeah, that clocks them fairly quickly once we get down to it, doesn't it? All right, let's get Stormbreath Dragon. Let's play Mox. Yeah, let's play Mox and discard Island. Actually, I guess I didn't even need to do that. And let's play Blade Splicer. Okay, plays around Force Spike. Yeah, that's what we're doing. Pass the turn. I get hit into 5 by the True Name. And then I'm going to try and race. Oh, Snapcaster Bolt. Okay. Well, don't really know how I'm racing now. It's a shame that their Stormbreath can't block their True Name. Yeah, oh, I'm just dead now, aren't I? Okay. Well, like I said, doing nothing till turn 5 doesn't sound great. Banesler actually and Gideon both seem decent against them. Thalia did not. Banished Priest did not as well. They just have a lot of enter the battlefield effects and bolts and stuff like that. Bribery seemed okay. I could put in Wrath. I'm not loving that idea, though. I think we'll go with this. Wabam. Alrighty, yeah, we're going to keep this. This hand's great. We get to Mana Leak. Well, actually, what we're going to do is play turn 2 Soulfire Grandmaster. Hopefully, I don't play anything, and then I get to play turn 3 Geist and daze their turn 3 play. That would be the dream. And let's see what they lead on here. They're deep in the tank. They did mock turn 1 Mox Diamond last game, so they could have some explosive plays here. Or they could have a tap Sacred Foundry, you know, one of the two. Ooh. Yeah, I'm actually going to play the Colonnade because I really want to be able to play Geist next turn. And I hope I don't have to daze something this turn. There's not that many 2-drops I can imagine really wanting to daze. Oh. Can imagine dazing some 3-drops. Oh, do they have Mox Diamond also, and they're going to play a 4-drop on turn 2? That would be unfortunate. That would send this game into a very different trajectory, since instead of Geist into daze, it would be then be daze your 4-drop. Problem is, this gets... Yeah, I don't like it. I guess I should have tapped my mana. This gets True Name Nemesis. Next turn, I can cast True Name with backup. It doesn't seem like it works out for me. I'm just going to pass and Mana Leak whatever they played in this turn, and then I'm going to go Blade Splicer on 3 and Opposition on 4. At least that is my current plan. Suspend Riftwing. Get around my Mana Leak. Oh, they didn't have another land. Interesting. That actually makes me want to just play Geist here. Geist punishes Planeswalkers. It's also really good if they just left up Lightning Bolt here. And then I do have Opposition in hand. If I draw land, I can like take a turn off from attacking with Geist, then tap something, then attack. Glacial Opposition isn't exactly a combo because you don't get to use the... Well, that was an aggressive bolt. You don't get to use the Angel to tap anything. All right. If they don't hit a fourth land here, well, third land plus Mox, then I think I'm in pretty good shape. All right. Let's hit for six. And I think I'm just going to play the Blade Splicer. Oh, do they have Snapcaster? All right. Well, I'm going to mana leak that. I think Geist of St. Tract is too valuable here for me to want to let that go. Especially with opposition backup. Though I've drawn 2 5 drops in a row, that's not exactly where I want to be either. Riftwing's coming down next turn. Playing Blade Splicer into Riftwing doesn't sound super appetizing. Let's see. Because if I tap out for Blade Splicer, Rifting's going to come in and just immediately eat the token. On the other hand, that lets me then play opposition and use it, the Blade Splicer, to tap down the Riftwing. If I draw land, I suppose I could play opposition. That doesn't sound great. They're just bolting me. Okay, well, I feel like I'm in good shape if my opponent's firebolting me from 17 to 15 with no pressure on the board. That sounds pretty good to me. Just don't draw like a Sun Titan or something. Oh, ice my land. Okay, well, I actually don't care too much about that. Because I can just play Soulfire Grandmaster this turn, or Blade Splicer. I'm just going to play Soulfire. And hit my opponent. Basically, I don't want to lose the token for nothing, and if they want to bounce Soulfire or Celestial Colonnade, good for them. They can do that. If they bounce either one, I guess I'm not opposition tapping down my opponent's stuff next turn. Though if I draw an island, I can potentially do that. What you got? They hit 4 mana for the first time. Electrolyze my Soulfire. And just pass the turn, presumably. Let's go Blade Splicer and then Colonnade. And then pass, and then next turn I have opposition. Well, if they have no other creatures, I guess I could technically opposition Blade Splicer, tap Cloud's Gate, attack for 9. What's more likely is opposition, tap 2 things, attack for 6, put you to 2, and then put you dead next turn. But that'll really depend on what my opponent does. They also could do something like a Johnny Vengeance, kill your Golem, just based on the cards we've already seen. They do have Restoration Angel in their deck. That could be annoying too. Here's a Johnny Vengeance. And there's Kill Your Golem. Okay. Well, we're going to go opposition. And we're going to tap Riftwing Cloudskate. And then we're going to attack Johnny with the Geist and my opponent with the Angel. And then kills the Johnny, puts them to 7, so I have Lethal out if they don't leave enough blockers, because I can play Baneslayer Revelark and use it to tap something. I also am not in any real danger of dying here, and they can like flashback. I get Firebolt on my Blade Splicer, I suppose. Though I could also, if I draw a land, I'd animate Colonnade, declare attacks with Colonnade Geist, and then before blocks use Colonnade. Because it has vigilance, use opposition to tap something. That could be pretty sweet. Let's see what my opponent's got. Ooh, True Name Nemesis. Okay. That will put a halt to some of my beatdowns here. Though I could just go Gideon. Plus 2 Gideon. And then pass the turn, and my opponent has to attack with a True Name Nemesis. Upkeep, I'm going to opposition down. Actually, I think I'm going to tap down both their red lands and then have both of their creatures attack Gideon. I don't care too. They've already used Snapcaster and Bolt, So I don't really care too much if Gideon takes five here. And then next turn I get to attack for way more than lethal. Okay. We got that game. Do I want Wear Terror? Still probably not. Land tax on the draw seems a little marginal. Selfless Spirit, no. Alright, yeah, this all looks fine to me. Basically, the only question is, do I want Wrath of God to kill Selfless, or not Selfless Spirit, True Nemesis? But that just does not seem quite good enough. So, I am going to pass on that. Alright, this plays. Turn 2 Suspend Cloudscape goes a long way here. This is one of those games where I'm going to lose to my opponent having a Mox. If they, in fact, do have such a thing. Oh, Daze is nice. I really don't want to use Daze on turn 2, but if I can Suspend Skate on turn 2 and then Daze on their 3 drop, that could be pretty good. Really don't want to Daze a 2 drop here. And they don't have it. Okay. I'm not cracking my fetch because I would like to draw a land. Having Island on top would be pretty nice, actually. Solemn's good, too. Actually, Solemn's really good. Solemn helps fix my mana quite nicely. And it ramps out Sun Titan. It fixes the double blue for bribery. I mean, I might be in a position where I have to daze something here. But that's okay. What is my best draw next turn? Probably like Geist of St. Traft or Blade Splicer. I don't really have any good acceleration. Well, I guess I could draw Grim Monolith. Well, Mox means I'm probably going to have to daze something. Yep. Daze has been good, though. I mean, Daze is a powerful card. All right, Grim Monoliths? Any Grim Monoliths? Ooh, well, I drew Geist. Unfortunately, I had to use the Daze, so I'm not getting to slam Geist here, but drawing Geist isn't bad. And if I can draw another land and cast Solemn, that would be nice too. Oof, that's actually really punishing. Okay, Mox Diamond. Can I get a Mox Diamond? No, I can get Repeal though. I am probably going to repeal their Mox Pearl, but I don't really need to do it right now. And if they end up playing a Mox Diamond, repealing that would be pretty nice. There's just no card I would play if I repealed main phase. Like repealing and drawing a Mox Diamond or something doesn't help, and I don't have any one drops. If I get Restoration Angel, then I'm going to be pretty unhappy here. Because then I will end up having cast new relevant spells. Also, my Riftwing's coming out, but it's just not going to do very much. Teferi? That is gross. I'm going to get to bounce it with Riftwing, but it's still pretty bad. All right, let's repeal your Mox. Wait, why did I do that now? That made no sense. I thought it was end of their turn for some reason. Well, that's awkward. It means they get to replay the Mox and have 3 mana at instant speed. It's probably not going to matter, but it is just, there's no reason to do that. Alright, I need to draw a Mox Diamond myself, because if I can draw my own Mox Diamond, I can play a Solemn this turn, and then end up being in a spot where I can actually cast spells of relevance. Though I suppose Geist of St. Traft isn't the worst thing in the world. Alright, am I getting mana drained? That would be so gross. Oh, Time Walk. And I'm getting clicked now because I bounced their Mox. Oh, that's lovely. I mean, that's just justice, honestly. They've got to take Time Walk here. It's my only card that does something. I mean, I get to play Geist, so that's not the end of the world. But, ooh boy, that ended up being bad. Like, I do get to still play Geist this turn, and then next turn they could still Teferi, untap 2 lands, click me, and if they take Time Walk, still end up in kind of the same spot, but it is really funny. Well, let's see what they end up taking here. I mean, there are, I guess, a lot of options. Yeah, so they do take the Time Walk. And then I get to play Geist. I guess I don't really attack with Riftwing here. There's no real point. So I'm just gonna, yeah, play Geist past the turn. Then they play Teferi, and hopefully I end up in a spot where I can do something. I really need to draw Mox Diamond. I think this my deck is quite bad, and the main reason is it doesn't have good fixing or acceleration. So, or enough cheap interaction. So it's just in a spot where it just doesn't do anything. Like, granted, maybe my first hand ended up not working out well regardless in game one, but I just think too many games this deck's just not going to draw Mox Diamond and end up not having relevant plays till turn four or something. And that is not really where you want to be in a Vintage Cube. It's not acceptable. So, opponent could Teferi here. Not sure what their plan is. Okay, so they do have the Teferi. I have Commit Memory. I do have a Geist, which I could just attack with. And they haven't played a land yet. I assume they have one. They don't have a land? Oh, they're attacking with Vendilion? Yeah, I'll block. I think having fewer things on the board is better for me. Now, if I could draw Metamorph or something, that'd be nice. If they still have Mana Drain in their deck, yeah, this is not going to go very well. Well, now I draw the Mox. That's interesting. I'm just going to go for casting Bribery here. And if I get Mana Drained, I get Mana Drained. I don't... Oh, they even didn't even leave up Mana Drained mana. Oh, well, that's good. Stormbreath Dragon's not bad. They clearly don't have Mana Drain in their hand, yeah. They don't have Restoration Angel in their hand either. They do have True Name Nemesis in their hand. And Bolt. Yeah, Lightning Bolt as well. And Snapcaster Mage. Okay. Could get Recruiter. Yeah, let's just get Stormbreath. And let's attack Teferi with everything. And then this way Teferi dies no matter what. Well, Bribery, drawing Mox Diamond into Bribery may have actually put me ahead here. They can trade for Geist, but they lose Teferi here. And then I end up with a Stormbreath in play in their hand of Bolt, Trinity Nemesis, Snapcaster. I guess Snap, Bolt, Snap can kill Stormbreath, but I have Solomon hand to get up to 6 mana, and if I draw a land, I can just play Sun Titan and get back Geist. Are they going to Bolt me? My opponent really likes bolting me. I have noticed that. If I spent more time, I could probably figure out exactly what their cards are. Like Chart of Course might be one of them as well. So they have 6 cards in hand, and Bolt, Snap, True Name are 3. I think Chart of Course actually might be number 4. And then 2 other things. I don't know exactly what. Okay, they drew Trinket Mage. And, but what else do they have to get? Oh, they have Mox Emerald. They have a lot of Moxen. Oh, they already double bolt. No, they're Exquisite Firecrafting the Storm Breath. Okay, so they have Bolt Snap. Oh, and they draw Sun Titan. Yeah. Are we going to steal this game? I kind of think we are. And let's get the Goose. The Goose is, in fact, loose. And then my opponent can Bolt Snap Bolt. I guess they can Bolt Snap Bolt and play True Name, which is pretty unfortunate. So they can kill Sun Titan and play Trinity Nemesis. So we're actually not doing as well as I would like. Because I actually still need to draw another threat. Drawing a Baneslayer would be nice, though. That would be quite good here. Or a Phyrexian Metamorph would also be something I would take. Alright, so we've got Solemn. I guess they have a Trinket Mage they can attack with now. I'm not gonna block. Oh, Blade Splicer's interesting. Let's just play Solemn. The reason I want to get Solemn into play is because next turn maybe I can play Blade Splicer and Commit to Memory. The Booth. Island. And it reshuffles my Time Walking. The Time Walk a little less good now that Sun Titan is gone. I'm kind of on the plan of they need to draw like two land in a row because they unfortunately have answers to everything. Though they may be in a spot where if they attack poorly, I end up getting an advantage. All right, well, that looks like the right attack to me. Opposition would be a sick draw. Time Walk's interesting. Let's cast Time Walk. See if they have drawn Mana Drain, I suppose. Play Blade Splicer. And then attack with Solemn Simulacrum. Oh, it is first strike now. Ha! That's wonderful. And then next turn I can attack for 5. Oh, Sphinx's Rev. Wow, that was a good draw. So let's... can I attack with Blade Splicer? No, there is no attack with Geist either. Just attack for 5 here. And I think I'm just going to Rev now. Like, my opponent doesn't have Mana Drain or Mystic Confluence in hand. So I'm just going to Rev now. Now I get to play my land, which is nice because it was a Colonnade. And then next turn I can play Opposition and tap down their blockers and hit with Baneslayer. Ooh, they probably didn't draw something good because they just played and cracked Strand. They would have done that last turn, I think. Because they're just doing it to thin their deck, which actually usually not worth paying a life to do that anyway. And then now I get to play Opposition and can't actually, and I probably just leave Commit up as the other thing I do here. And then I get to Opposition, use Blade Splicer and Solemn. Well, maybe not. I was going to try to tap down some things, but I guess we're getting Firebolted. Is my Solemn going to get Firebolted too? No, they did not attack. Interesting. Got a lot of options here. I guess if I play Baneslayer, I don't leave up Commit to Memory. What if I just play Opposition, leave up Commit to Memory, and pass the turn here? And then next turn, I can tap down 2 of their things, and then I attack them for lethal with Celestial Colonnade. Preordain. Okay. What do they got? Something good? I suppose I should actually look if they kept on top or not. They put 2 on the bottom. Nahiri. Oh yeah, we're going to Commit to Memory that one for sure. That would be exiling Opposition. But now they're presumably dead. They're taking 9, 13 damage. Thanks to my squad. All right, tap down this. Yeah, I know I have some leagues ending soon. Don't worry, we're ending this one very soon. Draw. Animate. Wow. Well, what was key was saving the Time Walk for when I really needed it, which was much later. So letting them Mendelian click my Time Walk actually worked out pretty nicely for me. And they've already used Bolt, so they take 12 here. And bam, we got there despite our best efforts. And, well, squeaking out win number 1 with this deck was already a pretty big accomplishment. So let's see if we can get 2 more. They had Chrome Mox in hand. Too many Moxen. See, that's the problem. I couldn't get flooded on Moxen because I just didn't draft any. Alrighty, time for round 2 here. I'm going to keep this hand. We barely won round 1. In fact, I think we kind of stole it. So I'm not counting my chickens here, but hey, I mean, starting 1-0 is pretty nice, especially when I thought I was going to lose. And then this hand is not too bad. I can Dahlia into Blade Splicer if I want. I could also turn to Time Walk and then play a Blade Splicer on turn 3. I suppose I could cast a... I don't need to upkeep stuff here. Oh! Interesting. Yeah, let's just cast a Blade Splicer here. Then if we draw a land next turn, I can go Time Walk and then cast Thalia. So that seems pretty decent. And then, let's see what my opponent's up to here. Triple blue. Three islands into a Metal Worker. Uh-oh. That is not great for me. Attack with the Golem. I do have a Metamorph, so that's nice. I'm just going to play Time Walk, play Thalia. If I end up drawing another land, I can hard cast Moldrifter and set up for whatever it is that comes next. Attacking for 5 here. All right, and I have a Riftwing Cloudscape. Let's see what we got here. How sick is this Metal Worker going to be? 3 islands and a Metal Worker. My body's ready for basically anything. All right, there's the 4th island, so only 5 cards in my opponent's hand. They could only have 14 mana this turn. Though that's assuming every card in their hand is an artifact, of course. What do you got? Show me the money, as it were. All right, here we go. Metalworker is being tapped, revealing Walking Ballista, Lodestone Golem, and Chrome Mox. All right, so Walking Ballista it is, I suppose. So Ballista for 3 and then a Lodestone Golem. Well, Ballista for 3 is a little annoying. Thalia is down. Oh, we're imprinting on Chrome Mox? What did we imprint? Wait, did we imprint nothing? Oh, we're tinkering. Okay, well, with Metamorph and Cloudskate in hand, I'm not feeling too bad about this. And yeah, like, Inkwell Leviathan's actually fine for me. Because I get to attack my opponent down to 10 here. And then Metamorph the Inkwell. And my opponent's hand is a Lodestone Golem. So then I have them on way faster of a clock than they do for me. They can attack me on a 13. My Inkwell puts them to 3. And then I can bounce one of their creatures. I guess even if I bounce a creature, I'm still not doing lethal next turn, but it's going to be really hard for my opponent to get in the last 6 points of damage before my Inkwell kills them. Especially if they have to use some Walking Ballista counters on the unblocked creatures I have. Having the dual threat of Riftwing Cloudskate and Metamorph in hand was pretty good against my opponent's Tinker. Though my opponent's deck looks sick. Mono blue artifacts with Tinker, Inkwell, Metalworker, Ballista, Lodestone Golem. That's some pretty good action. Alright, opponent drew a Celestia Signet since last turn, so their hand right now is Golem Signet, 1 unknown. They're going to buff the Walking Ballista. Shoot down the Moldrifter, leaving 1 counter. And their last card is Lodestone Golem, or Island, to play Signet Golem. Alright. So they're going to attack with their Leviathan. I'm going to take it. Land. If I bounce the Lodestone Golem with Riftwing, then their Ballista, I guess, doesn't. It just has to block the Golem at the very least. All right, so that seems good enough for me. Spend my 6. I just like forcing a Ballista chump because that's one of the ways they can spend a lot of mana next turn. Attacking with the Blade Splicer is kind of irrelevant, given that they have to block the Golem. They're just going to shoot down the Blade Splicer, most likely. But this leaves them, can't imagine very many outs. They're at 3 facing down Inkwell Leviathan, and a Riftwing and a Golem for good measure. All right, we took game 1, despite my opponent doing a lot of broken stuff. If this was the other way around, I would run it. I'm definitely going to run Duplicant. Thalia is looking less good here. I do like Wrath of God. I think against Walking Ballista, I'm supposed to turn into a deck that is more focused on controlling the game. Lindvala is good against Both Walking Ballista and Metalworker, and then Gideon Jura. Taking on Mary Angel. It is good with opposition. Repeal I like against Chrome Mox. Is it insane to take out Geist? It does get blocked by Lodestone. Maybe Walking Ballista, Inkwell. Well, I guess Inkwell is not really the great argument. Yeah, I think I'm going to try taking out that, and then I'll take out a Daze. All right, let's play the more controlling game here. Daze, because my opponent's just a big mana deck. All right, well, I'm glad I took out Daze here. I am going to keep this hand. I think this hand... Oof, Plains off the top was really bad. Remember, this deck has really bad mana. Mine is not where I want to be. Oh, they are playing white. I thought they were just playing Celestia Signix as a mana rock, but looks like they are, in fact, playing white. Solemn is nice, though. Solemn gets me to blue mana. I think my hand's fine. If they tinker, I can Wrath. I've got Metamorph if they play a juicy target. No, this is a tinker. I guess Darksteel Claw or Bladesteel Colossus would be pretty bad. Alright. Ooh. Alright, let's play Gilded Lotus. And I could Metamorph. I don't have any islands in play, so I get the first attack. That's cute, but I think unnecessary. I think I'm going to play Solemn, though. I'll take some damage, but I think I can get more cards out of my opponent here. Get an island. Because I get to... Oh, I guess I don't get to chump, but I get to Wrath away my Solemn next turn, and then... potentially Wrath away if they play like a Lodestone Golem or something here. Oh yeah, Metalworker. Yeah, this worked out nicely. Also played around Force Spike for whatever that's worth. I've drawn basically all mana sources so far, but it's not a big deal. Alright, let's play an island. I guess I didn't need to play an island because they can't Spell Pierce me anyway. And I wanted to be in a position to be able to play Colonnade if I drew it. Oh, Time Walk. I'm actually going to pass on casting Time Walk here because what I can instead do is untap Grim Monolith and then next turn maybe go threat Time Walk in the same turn. If my opponent plays something good to Metamorph, for example, or I just draw a good threat. You know what I really want to draw is Sphinx's Revelation. That would be insane. What do we got? Alright. I got a nice little 4-for-1 off that Wrath because the Solemn... And the Solemn actually drew me two cards. It drew me a card and a land. So it was an even better deal than that. So I'm pretty solidly ahead. But I also have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 mana sources. So I'm giving back some of those cards. And Ballista for one, sure. Well, no good Metamorph target here. Oh, I really want to draw Sphinx's Rev. That would be sick. I think I can still do better with this Time Walk. If my opponent doesn't play anything, then maybe I just have to burn it. But like, if they just animate Colonnade and hit me for 5, then yeah, I'm probably going to burn Time Walk no matter what I draw. But if they play a decently sized creature, I can go Metamorph Time Walk. And if I draw some kind of threat, I'm just going to pass again. If I draw lands every turn, I am going to lose. I'll tell you that much. I'm just going to pump their Ballista in a turn here. Yep. I really don't want them to attack with the Celestial Colonnade this turn. Oof. Okay, they did not attack. Good. All right. Well, I'm going to use Time Walk now, because otherwise I'm taking potentially lethal next turn. All right. Well, that getting a 4-for-1 and a 2-for-1 is not going to help me if I end up in a spot where I just draw all lands afterwards. All right, I guess duplicate is a card. I'm at 10, I fall to 8. That's 2 turns of Colonnade action. Oh. Or I get Cryptic'd. All right. Well, that's not good. Opponent is choosing not to attack with Colonnade, which usually means they have stuff to play, which could be bad news, but... but it also could be fine if they play something where using Metamorph on it gives me an advantage. Funnily enough, Walking Blitz is one of the few threats they can be hitting me with where Metamorph just doesn't do anything. Gideonjur, I guess, is another one. Alright. Rev. Ooh, Bribery. This could be interesting. Dragonlord Ogre Sun Titan? Man, Sun Titan does not do much for me. What else is in their deck? Black Lotus, wow. Gild Lotus, Grim Monolith, Jace, Mindslaver, Supreme Verdict, Teferi. Oh, their deck's a little more different than I thought. Wrath is good against Tinker, but and I guess Ojutai. But, all right. None of these are really that exciting. I guess I have to get Sun Titan, even though I have no targets. And then I'm just going to copy the Sun Titan. These are some sad Sun Titans. Just make some 6/6s here. What am I hoping to draw next turn? Still probably Sphinx's Revelation is my guess. Because now Gideon can come in. That's not great for me. And at the very least, Colonnade as well. So I get to chump, and I guess I'm chumping with the Metamorph. It's an artifact. Sure. Alright, I'm at 4 against a Ballista. Don't love that. And they get to Trinket Mage for their Lotus. Nice. All right. Time to draw Rev and draw 9 cards and gain 9 life. Something along those lines. Or a Misty. All right. We are done here. Well, that was kind of brutal. All right. Given what I know about their deck, Banished Priest is out. Geist is definitely in. And Thalia looks like it's going to be in as well. Mary Angel, Gideon did not seem great. Linval seemed okay still. This is too many. Also no days in right now. Still think duplicate's probably fine. Certainly bribery is still fine. On the play I might want days as well. Maybe I just don't want Wrath. Yeah, I can beat Tinker. I've got Metamorph and Bribery. We got this. And I have to cut one card. Is it supposed to be duplicate? Supposed to be repeal? I guess it could be repeal. Alright. I would like to play first. Yeah, I'm going to keep this hand. This is essentially a turn 3 Linvala using a Time Walk as a mana accelerant. Alright. Turn 1 Lodestone Column. Oh, that actually could be worse. Like, I get to go turn 2 land go, turn 3 Time Walk, turn 4 Solemn, and then probably Bribery on the next turn. So my opponent has to have good follow-up to this, which so far they have. I mean, they still have a turn 2 Signet. Oh. Nah, we don't have enough time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that, unfortunately. Setting up the Soulfire Grandmaster win is just a little too ambitious. And I guess we chump, probably, yeah. And hope they have Inkwell Leviathan in their deck for me to bribery. That would be nice. Commit Memory is not bad. Land and bribery. They can't cryptic this, at least. Let's see what they got. This is essentially a turn 4 bribery. They can impulse trying to find their Inkwell. Alright, let's see if they're successful. Bribery is a silly card. I will give you that. Alright. They did not find the inkwell, and their deck still has Cryptic, Jace, Teferi, Tinker, all those things. Sun Titan, Metalworker, Dragon Lord, Ezra Titan. Alright. It's gonna get me an Inkwell Leviathan. Don't see a particular reason not to do that. They can't even attack this turn. And next turn, I can just keep Commit to Memory up. I can't quite play Soulfire and play Commit Memory, unfortunately. Lodestone Golem taxes me too much for that. Oh, Supreme Verdict, sure. Land and Soulfire Grandmaster. And I actually think I just play Linvala. Because I want to get some threats in, on the board, and this way I have commit with buyback next turn. And they didn't have Shackles in their hand. Okay, and they have a Metalworker which doesn't do anything. Okay, this works for me. I'm going to hit them and pass. They have one card left. Did I lock them out? I kind of did. I mean, I'm not going to play this end of turn because it could be Cryptic. But yeah, I really want them to play a card here. Mindslaver? All right. Yeah, this is sweet. Yeah, we're not getting Mindslavered here. Not today. And then hit them for five more. And pass. And if they don't play anything, I'm just going to put their Metalworker back on top, I think. Oh, they played Tundra. Just no, showing me that they don't have anything is a little rough. And so they're just dead now, right? I just attack them and then they... All right, we beat two superior decks. Let's see if we can go for a third. Alrighty, time for round three of this Vintage Cube Draft, where we've been punching above our weight class every single round. I want to remind you that these videos are brought to you by ChannelFireball.com. Remember to check us out for awesome free content. You know, cube drafts, you've got legacy videos, you've got articles, you've got everything. And, you know, a store that is selling all the magic you can handle and also buying cards. So you get a 30% bonus if you trade us cards. So go ahead and do this. Check out our YouTube page, all that good stuff. And let's watch this round three. I'm going to keep this hand because it is my only mana excellent in the whole deck, Mox Diamond. But you get to go turn one, suspend Cloudscape, turn two, Blade Splicer. That's a pretty nice little aggressive start. So I like the sound of that. And also against Plains, that's pretty good too. Let's crack Misty so we can draw fewer lands in the future. We have so many lands in hand already, really unlucky. Play a Mox. And suspend away the Cloudskate and pass the turn. Pretty decent little start, if I do say so myself. Ooh, playing against Boros. All right, let's see, we got turn two here. Another land. All right, I see how this is going to go. That's okay. We still got time. I can just rattle off opposition and then Revelork or Moldrifter. Oh, yeah, Moldrifter would be nice. I feel like I'm going to get something bolted. Oh, no. Interesting. Oh, playing against Jeskai. Metalworker again? Okay. We defeated a good Metalworker deck already. Ooh, Merry Angel. That's not bad. I guess I'm punished for playing my Misty. And hit with the Golem. Alright, well, I've got next turn a Riftwing coming in, so we'll see what my love can do here. Since I do love this fighting force here. Yeah, really not sure. I would love to draw opposition is what I'd really be looking for. Though it really depends on what my opponent has with this Metalworker. They're snapping it off. What do you got? Show me something. Crucible Worlds, don't care. Shackles, might care. Battlesphere, that's not great for me. Tangawire, don't really care. So it's basically just a battle ball, and I've got enough in the way of flyers. I might actually be okay. They have 10, 11 mana. Yeah, they can't quite... It depends on what their last two cards are. If they can play Battlesphere and play Shackles and activate Shackles, that could be problematic. But I guess I can bounce the Shackles. Yeah, this is going to be close. It's really going to come to what I draw in the next turn here. Oh. Well, never mind. This is a lot less close. We're getting Ulamogged? What in the world? Okay. How am I supposed to beat that? I kind of feel like I'm supposed to bounce Ulamog, and these are our last four cards, and hope to rattle off some sort of like time walk draw or a way to disrupt that metalworker. All right. Action. Opposition. Another land. All right, we're dead. Well, I thought I was getting there with the Angel of Marriage or Mary Angel draw, but we're not quite. I guess I put in Wrath. Definitely put in Linvala. Definitely like Bribery. I guess I'm out for Thalia. And sure, I'll take out a Repeal as well. Alright, I would like to play first. Yeah, I mean, I can't mulligan this hand. Well, that's for sure. I get to play turn 1 Colonnade, turn 2 Riftwing, turn 3 Bladesplicer, maybe turn 4 Linvala, and have Commit to Memory up. Let's play Celestial Colonnade. And see if my opponent runs it here. Alright, well, I drew the land, so I am going to get to play out that curve that I described. I mean, if I go 2, 3, 4 and then have Commit up, there's some amount of hands that is just good enough. Oh, Mishra's Workshop. This could get dicey. Is this a Lodestone Golem? No, it's turn 2 Solemn. Okay. Well, that's pretty good action. I'm still going to play Blaze, but I'm getting another red. So they have a Wildfire or something? Wrath looking pretty bad here. I just feel like against someone playing Mere Battlesphere, Wrath of God is going to be at least plausible. Double red is interesting. Not sure what they're going for there. And they ship the turn. Alright, well, I kind of feel like I'm supposed to keep up counter magic here instead of play Linvala, because I do have that Riftwing coming. And I'm going to hit the Golem. I'll have to plow through that Solemn at some point. They can get their card if they want. Oh, no blocks. Okay, well, that even more makes me want to just pass. I just don't know what they're up to. Very suspicious. Like, they could just play a Battlesphere this turn. Or a Metalworker? Sure. Metalworker I will allow, because I have a Riftwing Clouds Gate coming. And I also have a Linvala at some point, but I think I'm supposed to just bounce the Metalworker now. And then I can attack for 5. I don't hate drawing lands. Lands means that I'm building up towards Activating Colonnade, which is pretty nice. And then casting Linvala with Mana Leak up also. The other thing is that Mishra's Workshop is not great against Mana Leak, because it just doesn't count as a land when you're talking Mana Leak. So if my opponent's playing a non-artifact spell, I'm going to get to Mana Leak it. It does help them cast like a 4-mana artifact and pay for Mana Leak, I suppose. So in that sense, it does combat it. I think I just say okay if my opponent replays Metalworker here. Oh, they're playing a Signet first. Well, that's certainly fine. Ooh, they got to plus one mana by using Misha's Workshop to cast Celestia Signet. Is this the Wildfire? This is probably getting mana leaked. At this point, I don't even need to play Linvala. So I think I'd rather just mana leak here and then leave up Commit for next turn, because there's no guarantee that Commit can even counter something. I kind of don't care about Memory Jar, but I still think I'm supposed to mana leak it. With that much mana, there's just no reason to give them access to seven new cards. Draw. Time Walk would be insane. All right, let's just hit for six, because now I have Lethal with the Celestial Colonnade, and I have a Commit up, which will stop a lot of the stuff they could do. I also don't care about Metalworker very much. I do think they probably should have just played Metalworker plus Jar that turn. They played a Signet instead of a Metalworker, essentially, and it just really did not work out well for them. They also could have just led with Jar, and I wouldn't have been able to mana leak it. So, yeah, I don't think that was the sequencing I would have chosen. Opponents on six cards, one of which is Metalworker. I've got Commit up, which is going to stop whatever this is, I'm sure. And then do I still have Lethal? I guess I don't have Lethal, because they get to chump. Oh, never mind. Yeah, we're going to commit that. Yeah, I don't have Lethal because they get to chump the Golem with Metalworker here. But if I don't draw anything, I probably still just do that and force them to chump. Because that way they take 7 damage going to 2. I don't think there's any way I can win this turn. And their second mound was indeed for Wildfire. Yeah, Misty Reinforced is not going to do it. And they go to 2. There's not that much that saves them here. Because right now I've got 3 lethal threats coming next turn. Ulamog does, but they're going to be hard-pressed to cast Ulamog here, given that it's not an artifact. So then they have 7 mana that taps for Ulamog. Lotus Ulamog, kill my Riftwing and my Celestial Colonnade. That is technically an out. Another Wildfire will do it. I guess a way to cycle into Wildfire would kind of do the trick. So any sort of like cantripping card. But if it's not that, they're going to have a hard time dealing with this particular squad here. Let us see what my opponent's got. All right, turns out they did not have it. Let's see if we can go for the really implausible 3-0. I think I had the worst deck in all 3 of my matches. Lotus Bloom for Miser purposes? Our deck's perfect. We got this. Turn 1, Mox Diamond, Thalia. Turn 2, Geist of St. Traf. Turn 3, Time Walk. Doing it. No, but this hand's pretty good. This is a hand that would make or break off Misty Rainforest. Oh, my opponent mulliganed. We could be doing it. That's the hand of me rubbing my hands together in glee, steepling my fingers and saying, good, good. All right, opponent mulled to 6. Can I just draw Mox Diamond? Oh, man, that'd be insane. Oh. That's not Mox Diamond at all. Rift, turn 2 Sun Titan, get back a land would be so awesome. All right, time for a Green Monolith. Really looking for that Misty Rainforest. Oh man, we're gonna need to draw land here. We've got the Green Monolith. We've got the potential for a broken start. If we just draw Misty Rainforest, get to crack it, get an island, play Sun Titan, get back Misty. Next turn, use Sun Titan to play 2 lands and go Banisher Priest plus Time Walk or Riftwing or whatever. All that stuff would be really good. All right, they have the Mitchell's Workshop. They're working hard for that colorless mana. Let's see what comes out of it. Oh, we're 1 card short, Misty Rainforest. It's all I'm asking for. feel like it's not too much to ask for. Alternately, I just don't want to play a Revelork. It just doesn't do anything. No, I'm just going to pass the turn. It just accomplishes nothing to play one of these. This is just going to be an air elemental. I think I would rather just leave up the mana from Monolith for something awesome. A 6-drop artifact, like a Wurmcoil Engine or something? Maybe Ballista for 3. Oh, Chalice for 3. My opponent's doing big things. See, this is where the parade ends, huh? Bricking on that draw, I think, is going to be fatal. We have another chance, though. All right. Gild the Lotus. All right, that was actually a really good draw. Because now I can go Gild the Lotus Time Walk. And then, all right, and then if I draw a land, that's good. Still alive for Misty here. Blade Splicer, interesting. No, I think I'm just going to cast Riftwing on the Everflowing Chalice here. I'm just worried what my opponent could play next turn, and this sets them back quite a bit. And then I'm still alive to draw Misty Rainforest would be, I still think, the best draw, funnily enough. But there's a lot of cards I would not mind drawing here. Even just normal islands, not horrible. I just don't think Mana Leak is live right now. I feel like there's not very much it can counter that I would care about, so I don't really want to leave Mana Leak up. All right, Gild Lotus did make things exciting, though. Here's where I wish I boarded in Wear Tear, but I don't think the mana was quite there. If I draw a land, I hope this isn't Shackles. Shackles would be annoying. If I draw a land, I could also go specifically an island, Emery Angel, play an island, have Mana Leak up, just in case my opponent tries to play like Wildfire. Because I could counter Wildfire with Mana Leak, depending on what my opponent does this turn. Hopefully this is just like a Crucible of Worlds or something. Because that I can definitely deal with. This doesn't look like Crucible of Worlds at all. Could be a Tinker. But if it was Tinker, you wouldn't just go ham on that Everflowing Chalice and make it for 6 mana. Metamorph. Oh no! Oh, I thought they were going to bounce my Lotus. The fact that they did this means they have Ulamog in hand. So I have to leave a Mana Leak to counter Ulamog, but I'm still going to get my Gild Lotus eaten by the Mog Father himself. Ugh. Does drawing opposition get me out of this? I guess it doesn't. Into Tanglewire? All right. Wow, this has been brutality all over. All right, untap those two, or tap those two, then untap your Monolith, play a land. At this point, I can't leave up Mana Leak anyway. Blade Splicer, and pass the turn. And let's see what my opponent does. They can still cast Ulamog here, right? They tap Tanglewire, land, workshop, 3, 6, 9. Technically, they have to find a land to be able to cast Ulamog. I'm like beyond convinced they have it in their hand, because it would have been such a powerful play to bounce my Cloudscape. So, you know, if they have nothing else, I'm not necessarily dead to Ulamog. I am dead to Wildfire. Wildfire wipes me out pretty good. But Ulamog killing like Gild Lotus Golem token, then I tap down some things and Banisher Priest the Ulamog. I mean, that is a thing. Wildfire is just going to annihilate me, though. I guess that could be the other card they have. Yeah. Yep. All right. So they could not have Ulamog in hand. Wildfire would also lean you towards playing Metamorph on Lotus instead. Yeah, I get, I have to put my cards in my graveyard. All right, so these get tapped down. And draw nothing. Opponent has to tap down Tanglewire and probably a basic island. Really need to draw a land last turn. Though, if my opponent's out of gas somehow, I do have a handful of good cards and a Gilded Lotus, which will soon be unlocked on under Tanglewire. You know, I have a chance this game. It's not 0% that I win. Obviously, it's going to depend on what my opponent's next card is. Island, okay. Is it a Battle Sphere? Balance. Okay. I actually don't care too much about that. I'm going to keep Sun Titan. Like, I wasn't doing anything anyway, and now if I draw a land, I get to untap Grim Monolith, then replay Sun Titan, and probably win the game from there. I actually think I'm in better shape now than you might expect. So, opponent goes down to one. Fortunately, I can't untap Monolith quite yet. Because they need a threat, and they need it pretty fast. Because if I get to Sun Titan back, Blade Splicer, and then Banisher Priest, and then start getting back lands, I'm going to win really quickly. Obviously, they can just go land Mirror Battlesphere or something and just kill me, but I mean, at some point, they've got to have nothing, right? All right, just tapped on Island, so I just need to draw land here. Land. Well, okay. That is a card. It wasn't the land that I wanted, because then I could untap Monolith and replay Sun Titan. But I do get to keep up Commit to Memory now, and if my opponent misses for a turn here, I at least get Commit to Memory up. And then I could be in decent shape. Don't Battle Ball me. Oh, Pentad Prism? Sure. Okay. I feel like I'm actually winning now. Just pass. If my opponent doesn't do anything of note, I get to Sun Titan them. Yeah, and there's a lot of things that they could do that I also wouldn't care about to use Commit here. They're only one mana short of Ulamog, I guess. I suppose that is kind of annoying. Burning to destroy my land? Okay. Now my opponent's grasping at straws. Like, that's... They've just paid 6 mana and sacked a land to kill my land. Yeah, this is going to be fine. I might as well play my land first. Sun Titan. Oof. Are we going to 3-0 with this deck? That's insane. This deck is so bad. Let's just get Blade Splicer. No real point to getting a land here since I still can't cast Commit. Next turn I'm going to have Commit up. They have one turn to do something. My opponent's just... The first Wildfire was insane. Obviously, they should cast that. The Balance and the Burning were a little spewy, and things are actually working out pretty well now. Inferno Titan? Yeah, okay, that actually doesn't matter. They're not beating me with an Inferno Titan. So the question is, do I want to just Lotus? Because I'm going to get Banisher Priest now. Yeah, it can't possibly be worth casting Commit on their Everflowing Chalice or Gilded Lotus right now. Because if they get to enough mana to cast Ulamog, if they play a land and say go this turn, then I'm probably going to do that. But right now they're 2 mana short of Ulamog, so unless they go Ancient Tomb Ulamog, it's just not going to work. Crucible of Worlds, okay. They get to play their land. So now they're going to be able to cast Ulamog in a turn. Let's untap Grim Monolith. I think, yeah. Oh, they get to play their last card of Vidalkin Shackles. One island. They're going to go to 2 islands. 3, 6 seconds. They could have Ulamog next turn. They're at 13. Next turn I'm attacking them for 9. I feel like I can let them... No, letting them have that just can't be good. Alright, let's put their shackles back on top. Draw. Sun Titan back. Land. And then play a Mold Drifter. Would be sick if I drew Days for Ulamog. Alright, well, there's that Misty I wanted so badly. I probably lose to Ulamog here. But I think that's like the only card I lose to. And even then, do I actually lose to it? They get to kill Sun Titan and Banisher Priest, get back Inferno Titan. But they did not draw Ulamog. They might have drew Memory Jar. Oh, no, they drew Signet. We did it. We 3-0'd. After having no lands in play when my opponent had 10 mana. This is great. Play a land. I really want to cast Commit to Memory, but I can't justify it, so I'm not going to. Oh, man. All right. Well, there we go. 3-0'd with that extremely rancid cube deck and very mediocre deck, but we got there. That's a really good way to close out cube season. Though, maybe I'll do another one at midnight, the night before the cube goes away. Who knows? Plus, here's a Dredge deck. Might be coming to a video near you. Thanks for watching, everyone. Remember to support ChannelFireball.com if you like the content, and we'll keep making more of it. Thanks a lot for watching and hanging out as we 3-0'd with really not the best cube deck.